Hello everyone. In this video, we'll be exploring frequency divider circuits, specifically the circuits that take an input signal of a frequency f and generate new signals with frequencies that are fractions of the original, such as f over 3, f over 5, or f over 7, etc. In these circuits, starting with one clock source, we can create slower clocks at precise ratios, which are very useful in many digital systems. Before we dive into the details, let's review two important concepts. First is the frequency division using a D flip-flop. If the output Qn, that is Q bar of a D flip-flop, is fed back to its D input, and a clock signal of frequency f is applied at the clock, the output Q toggles at every rising edge of the clock. As a result, the output at Q has a frequency of f over 2. The second concept is the effect of sampling on different clock edges. If the signal applied to the D input is synchronous with the rising clock edge and is also sampled at the rising edge, the output appears one full clock cycle delay later, that is, with a delay of T. However, if the input is synchronous with the rising clock edge, but is sampled at the falling edge, the output appears with a half cycle delay, that is T over 2. In the first circuit over here, the input to the flip-flop is applied and sampled at the rising edge, and the output is delayed by T. In the second circuit, the input to the flip-flop is applied at the rising clock edge, but is sampled at the falling clock edge. In this case, the output is delayed by T over 2. Now let's look at frequency division circuits. In an earlier video, we learned that frequency division can be achieved using counter circuits. Let's build upon that idea and design a divide by 3 circuit. To do this, we'll create a mod 3 counter. A mod 3 counter simply counts in the sequence 0, 1, 2, and then resets back to 0, repeating the cycle. To build this, we use two D flip-flops, FF0 and FF1. Normally, a counter with two flip-flops would count 0, 1, 2, 3, and then return to 0. Here is an example of an asynchronous mod 4 counter that does exactly that. To get a mod 3 counter, we want to limit the sequence to only 0, 1, 2. To achieve this, we reset both the flip-flops whenever the condition FF0Q equals to 1 and FF1Q equals to 1 is true. Notice that in this circuit, the flip-flops use an active low reset. So to generate the reset pulse, we connect FF0Q and FF1Q to a two-input NAND gate. When both the outputs are 1, the NAND gate briefly outputs a 0, creating a reset pulse. This clears both the flip-flops back to 0, and the counter starts again from the initial state. Effectively, the circuit passes through a temporary 1-1 state only for a few nanoseconds before resetting to 0-0. In this diagram shown over here, this duration is stretched out for clarity. The result is a sequence of 0-1-2 back to 0, which is exactly what we need for a mod 3 counter. Now, if you look at the signal at FF1Q, you see that its frequency is f over 3 or the time period is 3t, but its duty cycle is about 33%. Just to recap, duty cycle is the percentage of time a signal stays on or logic 1 during its total time period. It is calculated by dividing the on time by total time period and multiplying by 100. In most practical cases, we prefer to generate clock signals with 50% duty cycle, which have equal high time and low time. Now let's discuss how we can generate a signal of frequency f over 3 with 50% duty cycle from a signal that has 33% duty cycle. Looking closely at the waveform FF1Q, we can see that FF1Q is high for one clock cycle and low for two clock cycles. Let's recall the concept which we discussed earlier. If the input is synchronous with the rising clock edge, but is sampled at the falling clock edge, the output is delayed by half clock cycle, that is T over 2. Using this idea, if we take FF1Q and pass it through another D flip-flop clocked on the falling edge, the resultant signal, which we'll call FF1Q delayed, is shifted by T over 2. Finally, if we take the OR of FF1Q and FF1Q delayed, the output is a signal of frequency F over 3 and duty cycle of 50%. Another way to understand this is by looking at the truth table. FF1Q is 1 for 1 clock cycle and 0 for 2 clock cycles. By delaying it by half a clock cycle, that is by sampling on the falling clock edge, and then ORing the two signal, we obtain the desired F over 3 output with a 50% duty cycle. Now let's design a divide by 5 circuit. For this, we'll use 3 flip-flops. And first, build a mod 5 counter. A mod 5 counter counts through the sequence 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, and then resets back to 0, repeating the cycle. We implement this with 3 flip-flops, FF0, FF1, and FF2. In general, 3 flip-flops count from 0 to 7. To restrict the count from 0 to 4, we detect the binary sequence 101 and reset the counter to 000. Practically, we assert reset when FF2Q is 1, FF1Q is 0, and FF0Q is 1. Effectively, the counter reaches state 101 for a brief moment before being cleared to 000, generating the sequence 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, and back to 0. That is the mod 5 counter. Looking at the waves in this design, FF2Q is high for one clock cycle out of five clock cycles in the time period. So it produces a waveform of frequency F over 5 and a duty cycle of around 20%. Now let's enhance this to produce a divide by 5 output with a 50% duty cycle. To generate a divide by 5 output with 50% duty cycle, let's carefully examine FF2Q and FF1Q. FF2Q is high for one clock cycle and low for four clock cycles. To achieve a 50% duty cycle, the high and low times must each last for 2.5 clock cycles. The idea is to extend the high portion of the signal so that it covers 2.5 cycle instead of just one. To do this, we take FF1Q, which is high for two consecutive clock cycles, pass it through another D flip-flop that samples on the falling clock edge. This delays FF1Q by half a clock cycle, that is T over 2. When we OR this delayed FF1Q with FF2Q, the result is a signal that is high for 2.5 clock cycle and low for 2.5 clock cycles, giving a frequency of F over 5 with a 50% duty cycle. So far, we discussed 1 over 3 and 1 over 5 frequency divider circuits. Pause this video now and try to reason out a 1 by 7 divider on your own. You will very likely figure it out. If you want to confirm your reasoning, here is a divide by 7 circuit that produces a 50% duty cycle output. To achieve this, we first design a mod 7 counter, an asynchronous counter with 3D flip-flops that can normally count up from 0 to 7. To make it mod 7, we reset the flip-flops when the count reaches 6, that is, when FF0Q is 0, FF1Q is 1, and FF2Q is 1. If we examine the FF2Q signal, in each cycle it stays high for 3 clock cycles and low for 4 clock cycles. To balance this and achieve a 50% duty cycle that is equal high and low times, we take following steps. Pass FF2Q through another D flip-flop and sample its output on the falling edge of the clock. This introduces a half clock cycle delay, and when we perform an OR operation between FF2Q and FF2Q delayed, the result is a signal with frequency divided by 7 and a 50% duty cycle. This is all for this video. I hope this explanation helped you to understand frequency divider circuits and the reasoning behind them.